Well, I guess it all started, you know. My earliest memory was that I used to see so many people doing so many things, so many guys and money and girls, and I thought to myself, man, that must be nice.
Hey, yo, you that just flipped on this CD player, I just want to inform you that when you got somebody good, you hold on to them.
Understands the life you live.
Must be nice.
Having someone who's slow to take and quick to give.
Must be nice.
Having someone who sticks around when the rough times get thick.
Someone whose smile is bright enough to make
projects feel like a match.
Having
someone who loves you despite your faults.
Must be nice.
Having someone who talks the talk but also walks the walk.
Must be nice.
Having someone who understands that a thug has feelings too.
Someone who loves you for sure. You just remember to never let them go.
Even when your husband lays on the
even when
she'll be by your side still home.
You can come home to from a long day work.
Must be nice.
Having someone you don't have to show, they know exactly where it
must
hurts.
Be nice.
Having someone who trusts you despite what they've heard.
Someone as mighty as a lion,
but still as gentle as a bluebird.
Must be nice.
Having someone you don't have to tell, you don't want to be long.
Must be
no.
Nice.
Having someone you can grow old with until God calls
must
you home.
Nice.
Having someone who understands that a thug has feelings too.
Someone who loves you for sure. You never let them go.
Cause even when your husband days are gone,
and they will be
by your side still home.
And all those gold digging women will disappear.
She'll still be here.
She'll still be there.
Even when your husband is gone,
even when your husband is
gone, she'll be by your side still holding on.
Holding on, holding on.
Even when those women start spinning, and all those gold digging women disappear, she'll still be.
And all those gold digging women disappear, she'll still be here.
Well, I guess the next part of the story is that after all this lusting and all this time, I finally found me somebody for me, somebody I could tell the way I feel about you.
Your brother just got out. Yeah, 2 weeks ago, he doing good too.
Girl, I still get you, but when I think about how this time done tore us apart, but you will never fall from my mind or from my heart. Girl, you know the way I feel about you. She finally bought that house.
It's little, but it's hers.
I'm betting that makes your mama proud.
Yeah, she happy
to see all the hard work of raising y'all paid off. Girl, that's what I'm talking about. So when you come back in town, maybe we can go somewhere and hang out.
I like that.
'Cause no matter where you are in this world, to me, you will always be my girl. Don't you see?
You know the way I feel about you. You know the way I feel about you. Now and forever.
And just when I thought, okay, I like her, she good for me, you know, I find out she got kids. Mm-hmm. I mean, I know what you're talking about, brother, so let me tell her.
Somebody's gotta say, show I'm nominating myself to deliver the news that it's hard for a man to choose a lady that already got a baby. And though his feelings may be strong, having kids that don't belong to him, holding on to him somehow seems wrong to him. Exposing them to a man who may one day decide he's tired of a family life.
Now he's gotta tell
that little girl a goodbye line.
He's the only dad
she's ever had in her life. And I don't wanna take that chance. Please don't take offense. It's just a thought of hurting somebody that was innocent.
She got kids.
Don't know if I'm ready to give.
They're the things that they need to live.
'Cause if we become more than just friends, what I do for her, I gotta do for them kids. I just wanna make sure this is
more than just a sexual trip.
All I wanna do is prevent those kids from getting hurt again. Most men think it, but they'll never say it. What if y'all had another baby? And he's accused of choosing favorites.
They're right.
Would it be wrong for loving his own flesh and blood a little more? Is it being human or it being immature?
Who's to say?
That's why it's better just to wait. Take a day to day. Let love spread its own wings. And if
if it wants to fly away or if it decides to stay. It won't be because of any unrealistic expectations, yours and mine.
He won't have to pray.
That little girl ain't away.
He takes a while for dawn.
So he won't have to explain.
I don't wanna take that chance.
Please don't take offense. Just don't need that kind of drama on my conscience.
She ain't got kids.
Don't know if I'm ready to give.
They're the things that they need to live.
Cause if we become more than just friends, what I do for her, I gotta do for
them kids.
I just wanna make sure this is
more than just a sexual trip.
All I wanna do is prevent those kids from getting hurt again.
Then, even knowing that she got kids, after all the, you know, being concerned and all the worrying, I just realized that, you know, I have feelings for her, and I just can't see her being with nobody else. I just can't.
Touching, see, I don't wanna
And you know, things went good. Hey, I was a happy man. She was a happy woman. And then, you know, how you get to that couple year turn or whatever, and we were just bouncing back and forth. Well, if early in the relationship, what if this happened, hypothetically?
What if I broke a monogamous agreement? What if I told you one lie but didn't mean it? What if my one mistake had the potential to break up our happy home?
Would you wanna know?
What if I confessed it, and though she didn't mean nothing, since it happened, you're thinking about leaving?
What if I suppressed it
and made a vow to never mess with another? Is it cool for me to smother the facts? Is it cool for me to cover my tracks?
If you never know,
oh, would me not being honest hurt you more?
Hypothetically, of course, all that some things better left unsaid. Would you wanna know instead? Hypothetically, of course, are there some wars not worth fighting? Some tears not worth crying? Hypothetically, of course, what if this happened to you? What would you want me to do?
What if I told you that I had a confession? What if I said 4 years ago when we were arguing, he came to comfort me and I wound up pregnant, and I just can't say for sure
if the baby's yours?
Now what if I confessed it and it turned out not to be your baby after you get tested and destroys what we've been blessed with?
What if I suppressed it?
Technically, you're the baby's daddy anyway.
Is it wrong for me to want you to stay?
Could you rather have me tear you away
from the only family you know?
Or is it just too big a secret to keep it on the low? Oh, yeah.
Hypothetically, of course, are there some things better left unsaid? Or would you wanna know instead? Of course, are there some wars not worth fighting? Some tears not worth crying? Hypothetically, of course, what if this happened to you? What would you want me to do?
Would you want to know?
Would you want to know?
Tell me what you do.
Tell me what you do.
Would you walk away or would you stay?
Would you want to know?
Would you want to leave the past behind us?
Or are you afraid that one day it might find us?
Would it even matter?
Could it even matter?
Should it even matter?
Needless to say, I mean, neither one of us wasn't feeling, especially me. So, to switch places with a woman, I got my stuff, and I left. And you know what? That was the first time in a while I really smiled.
Spread my wings and reach the sky. I never fail so alive. Kiss
kiss my kids goodnight. Tell them that he's alright. I'm all right now.
Honey, child, there's a whole world waiting on you. To the wild world we finally made it through. Go ahead, big smile. Now all that darkness behind you. Smile, smile, smile.
Feels like I've been baptized. Almost drowned, but I survived. She helped me under for 5 years of my life. Well, today I'm living proof. Your worst fear came true. I'm doing all right without you, baby. Yes, I am. I'm leaving all those grudges behind me, throwing fear out the window. So when these lessons come to find me, they will have room to breathe and grow. Let my blessings overflow and get my life under control, so my kids will know that it finally let go. I finally let go.
Honey, child, there's a whole world waiting on me.
There's a whole new world.
To the world, what a finally made it through. Go ahead, big smile. Now all that darkness behind you. Smile, smile, smile. Blue skies.
Blue skies are calling you.
No more teary eyes.
Full steam ahead now.
Despise you at all.
I thank you for the lessons you have taught me. Oh, oh, oh yeah.
Blue skies,
oh, they're clear and blue.
No more teary eyes.
No crying for you, babe.
I don't despise you at all.
Yo, I was having a ball. I gotta say, I was having a ball. But then, you know, I don't know, maybe she just didn't want to see me having a ball, you know? She's sick of the child support folks on me. I don't really got no money like that for all what she wanted. So, I mean, to basically put it as nicely as possible, the lady was, felt like she was being kind of greedy.
Man, don't make no sense. Every time I see no sense. Every time I see the police, I gotta be ducking and hiding.
See, I'm a wanted man, barely living in these streets. Send child support, soft fit to put a warrant out on me. See, I owe them $6,500 and they want their money. And it's so funny, cause they know I ain't got that kind of dough. Like it's my fault that she got on welfare. I told her we can go half on a sample like half a daycare. But no, she got comfortable at the bottom and wanted to stay there. And I don't know how this gonna turn out, so y'all keep me in prayer.
Oh, this crazy, lazy lady, using this baby for revenge and money. And I don't think it's funny that she plays the innocent mother when it's the other way around. She ain't needed, she greedy.
See, when I start back working, they gon' take all my dough. And then they wonder, well, what the hell I ain't working for? All of this attention haunts this boy about some back child support. When they're killing each other by the dozens out here, every day just for sport. With bills stacked up to his city 10-10, summoning him to court. Then all of his friends call him a worry wart. Not all the money they gave her, I gotta give it back. Like I was the one living rent free and getting food stamps.
Oh, this crazy, lazy, lazy.
just
whoa, great. This crazy, lazy lady, using this baby for revenge and money. And I don't think it's funny that she plays the innocent mother when it's the other way around. She ain't needed, she. Whoa, this crazy, lazy lady, using this baby for revenge and money. And I don't think it's funny that she plays the innocent mother when it's the other way around. She ain't needed, she greedy.
So she's sicking the police on me, right? And I didn't really have no money to get this lady. You know what I'm saying? It was either get some money or go to jail. Go to jail, get some money, you know. And I just went back to what I knew how to do best. I'm a stick-up kid. Yo. Y'all ain't gonna like what I'm about to tell y'all. Y'all gave the wrong dude a deal this time, boy. Yeah, I'm gonna take y'all back to how I used to be back in the 90s. Oh yeah, yeah. Yo, you done pictured everything else, now picture this.
Rolling in my Toro Monte Carlo, looking for somebody I can borrow. $5 or $10 till tomorrow. I'm doing bad, y'all. And I smoked my last pack of cigarettes today. You ever seen a nigga digging in the ashtray? It's a crumbling and humbling sight to see. I'm doing bad, y'all.
And they teasing me with these 23s and these DVDs and their rides. Then they pass me by, ba 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 ba, and have the nerve to wonder. I'm a stick up kid, that's how I live, I admit it.
And I'll be robbing these niggas.
I'm a stick up kid, and if you do it too much, I'm coming to get it.
I'll be robbing these niggas.
I'm a stick up kid, that's how I live, I admit it.
I'll be robbing these
niggas. I'm a stick up kid, and if you do it too much, I'm coming to get it.
See, lately I've been thinking about saving my soul, and the prayers make it to heaven from the ghetto. I asked all my friends, but they all say they don't know. It's all bad, y'all. And the preacher talking about some stuff he don't know. When church done became a fucking fashion show, and they won't let a nigga in with these Timbos. It's so bad, y'all.
And they teasing me with these 23s and these DVDs and their rides. Then they pass me by, ba 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 ba, and have the nerve to wonder why.
I'll be robbing these niggas.
I'm a stick up kid, that's how I live, I admit it.
I'll be robbing these niggas.
I'm a stick up kid, and if you do it too much,
nobody knows the trouble I see. Nobody knows but me. Nobody knows the trouble I see. Nobody knows but me. Oh, nobody knows the trouble I see. Nobody knows but me.
Yeah, and that only lasted briefly, you know. And then here come the police, handcuffing the brother off, taking me and throwing me in the cage with the rest of them. You know, I guess it was true what Mama always said. The same thing that make you laugh or make you cry.
I done had money and I done been broke. I done been talked about something awful. Done been lied on by so many folks. I done even been impressed at times and didn't want to cry cause my pride was too strong. But over the years I thought it over, and after struggling for so long and still holding on, I figure can't be nothing all that wrong with crying. If anybody says that that's strong, they're lying.
See, crying is like taking your soul to the laundromat. It's like a feeling that you get when you see your grandmama smile, or the heavens open up and blessings break down. Go on, child, and cry. Go on and cry, cry, cry. Go on and cry, cry, cry. We can cry, we can cry together. Yeah, I've been playing, and I done been playing. Yeah, I done went for some of the oldest tricks from some of the coldest chicks God done never made. But y'all don't hear me. Said I done even had of an avio disease. And didn't want to go to the clinic. All that attention embarrassing me. But over the years, I learned to understand that I don't really give a damn what nobody says. I'm a man.
Okay, next part of the story is that after about 5 or 6 years in the joint, I had cried all I could cry. And then, you know, other things was coming to me, more spiritual things was placed upon my heart. I start looking, you know, in different places for God. And I think my exact age was, I was 26 years and 17 days old.
Yo, what's up? Know my brother. Not today, I'm on my way somewhere. Huh? Now let me tell you a little story, man. What happened to me not that long ago, y'all? Tell me something.
See, I was looking for God at my grandmama's house. Underneath the cushions on the couch, I looked all around, side to side, up and down. That man was nowhere to be found. So I called my grandmama on the phone, said, old lady, you best get home.
cause God ain't where you said he would be. And there's something that I really need to speak with him about. Immediately she said, boy, tell Granny what's wrong.
Is there something I can do?
I said, big mama, now it's a sensitive issue, and Lord knows I don't wanna worry you, but I need somebody to talk to.
It has been 26 years and 17 days, been to 5 different prisons, got 2 babies on the way, and they say it'll be a waste of time to pray, seeing that I'm going to hell anyway.
It has been 26 years and 17 days, been to 5 different prisons, got 2 babies on the way, and they say it'll be a waste of time to pray, seeing that I'm going to hell anyway. Yeah, I done smoke weed with the best of y'all, shout out all the rest of y'all. My heart hurt like an old man with high cholesterol. Preachers say that I'm the dirtiest dude he ever saw. Shouldn't even be living. And he a Christian. Should have been dead like 17 times from 17 crimes I committed. Took them all to trial and got acquitted. Left waving my middle finger in the air, whispered in the prosecutor's ear.
Yeah, I
done stole everything from dreams to wedding rings. Auctioned off my soul for material things. But lately it's been kind of bothering me. I guess that turtle always catches up with the rabbit eventually.
It has been 26 years and 17 days, been to 5 different prisons, got 2 babies on the way, and they say it'll be a waste of time to pray, seeing that I'm going to hell anyway.
It has been 26 years and 17 days, been to 5 different prisons, got 2 babies on the way, and they say it'll be a waste of time to pray, seeing that I'm going to hell anyway.
Somebody loves you, baby.
Somebody loves you, loves you, loves
you. Oh, oh, oh. Somebody loves you, baby.
Well, you think no one does. Somebody loves you, baby.
Somebody loves you, baby.
Oh, somebody.
Oh, oh, oh. Somebody loves you, baby.
Somebody loves you. Somebody cares for you. Somebody does.
Somebody loves you, baby.
Ooh, 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 I promise you.
Oh, 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 somebody loves you, baby.
Cause it ain't no further, still a chance, still a way.
Somebody,
somebody loves
you, baby.
Somebody cares for you.
That's my jam. That's my jam right there. Patty is amazing. But what's even more amazing is that 4 years later, still in prison, I was still on the road to becoming a better person, a better father, a better son, a better individual, all around individual. But I saw a lot of fake things going on in the church. People, you know, faking like, you know, everybody else is bad and they ain't nobody holier than thou and all of that other stuff. And so I just came to a point to where I had made up my mind.
Yo, this is to all y'all. Yo, this is to all y'all good church going people. Talking about folks and don't be living right yourself. Y'all know who y'all is.
Lord, they really think they fooling you by coming to church on Sunday. Praying and laying hands on folks, stomping and jumping around, faking the Holy Ghost. But it's a thin line between walking it and talking it and living it and giving it or just pretending it's alright. And do they really think that they could pull the wool over your eyes, Lord? Do they really think that by faking they will save, that they will get the same reward? It's be the realest thing I ever wrote for sure. And after this, a lot of folks won't like me no more. But after this, I'm gonna go answer to you, Lord. So I made up my mind.
I'ma go to church on Sunday and sing a song that may hurt somebody's feelings so that maybe the will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And hopefully they will see how much they really be discouraging a little old sinner like me. Lord, who they think they jiving by singing these songs full of glory? Then out in the world, it's a different story. I'm running out of people to pray for me, and I'm not trying to act like I'm a perfect man. But if you speak about it, you should be about it, not just preach about it all day. 'Cause if you do, you run the risk of chasing some of the most beautiful people away. And it is never my intention to discourage you, rather encourage you to change your life today. Just be the realest thing I ever had to say. And after this, a lot of folks won't like me no more. But after this, I'm gonna go answer to you, Lord. So I've made up my mind, I'ma go to church on Sunday and sing a song that may hurt somebody's feelings so that maybe the will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And hopefully they will see how much they really be discouraging a little old sinner like me.
Yeah, none of y'all gotta clap for me. Yeah, your mama.
Hey, and then after 10 years and some odd months, they finally said, well, they letting the brother go. One of the happiest days of my life. And that night, I laid in my bed and I just reminisced over, you know, all the things that happened in my life, you know? And it was just, finally, they gave me back my life.
Alright,
I'll talk to you.
Get home safe.
Crazy kids. Yeah, today was a good day. Word.
She had a penny discriminated against. Talked about my friends. Played a fool by women. Had a daddy with no feelings. I lived in ghettos with my mama. We used a stove to heat our water. And had to share clothes with my brothers. Three of us in one bed, one coverall.
And those were the happiest days of my life. If it ain't rough, it ain't right. Street lights are coming on. Better get home, better get home. Those were the happiest days of my life. If it ain't rough, it ain't right. While we're reminiscing Christopher Reeves, you're still Superman to me.
You're still Superman. You're still Superman. Worthless, lonely, scared, and nervous in a world without no purpose.
Cried out to God, I didn't deserve it.
But He said in time I would see it's the bad times that made the good times.
Oh, yeah, oh, so good. And those were the happiest days of my life. If it ain't rough, it ain't right. Oh, street lights are coming on, better get home. Superman to me.
I said you're still Superman. Nobody's gonna take your place. 'Cause you're still, 'cause you're still Superman.
Let's go. Yo, I didn't change the
dirty diapers, cook food with lighters. Shot so much game, chicks nickname me Sniper. Famous ghostwriter, banker come retired. Too many zeros, poppy still illegal. Chain look like nickels, mixed with icicles. Stretching from the neck area to the genitals. I got a parrot on my shoulder that talk for me and he don't say shit. But nigga, back off from me. Yeah, I'm a hood nigga, but I'm still a good nigga. Bought a couple kids new bikes just cause I could, nigga. And I ain't one to be looking for thanks. I just ball cause I like the Yanks. Wow. 10 years and some odd months in the joint, and I'm finally home. I feel good. I'm looking good. You know what I'm saying? Things is different. Relationships is different. A lot of my friends is dead. A lot of my friends that's alive ain't really alive because they doing the same old thing they was doing 10 years ago. But yo, I was on the bigger and better things. Went on to New York. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't just talking about it. I was being about it. I wasn't just trying to be a better hustler, a better father, a better friend, a better cousin. I was trying to be a better person. And I found, just like in the joint, when you're trying to do positive things, positive results gotta follow. They gotta follow. So for the last cut of the album, I thought I'd give it to y'all and tell my brothers in the joint who's striving to do the same thing that it is possible, man. Lyfe is possible. Come on, y'all. For the last cut, let's do this right. Yo. Yeah, it's me. Lyfe. With the Y. And I'm dedicating this to all my brothers in the lockdown. You know, y'all know who y'all be. And I also want to dedicate this to everybody who been something for a long time, but been tricked into believing that they wasn't nothing. Y'all know who y'all be. For real.
This one's for my peeps locked up. Lord, we keep you in our prayers and ain't forget about you out here. No, call me whenever you feel, cause I know a lot of folks don't keep it real. I know they got their own life, but still,
when you love someone,
go. It's hard enough being alone, missing your family, missing your home.
Whether you're right or wrong, happy by your side,
keeping your hope alive. I know how it feels to cry, so you ain't alone in your struggle for life. To my people, shoots that ugly jumper from the foul line like you do. And your girl, she doing okay, but don't concern yourself with if she will or won't wait. You'll just drive yourself crazy with stuff you can't change.
Better ways to occupy your time,
opening up your mind. Troubling time out here. Your kids need your guidance, even from in there.
And no matter when or where, I
wanna abandon you, cause that
nobody but friends, dear.
Still got a lot of love.
And I pray to God through my actions, you know how much, yeah.
Forget about my folks down up in there. Yo, Popo, what's up, baby? Yo, young Billy Dotson, what up, baby? Young Smurf, ain't forgot about you. Dr. Black, what up, baby? Billy Dotson, second shout out to you, baby. Yo, can't forget about my mans and them. T Jesus up in there, baby. Hold it down, baby. Young X, ain't forgot about you, baby. Young Rodney, where the smoky things at, baby? Y'all think I'm playing? Yo, Styles. Oh, my God. I almost forgot about you, baby. Still have not, will not. You know what I'm saying? Yo, Preacher. Nigga, you still up in there cutting hair, nigga? Do your thing, my fam. Do your thing, my fam. You hold it down out there. I'm holding it down out here. That's how we doing it. Lyfe, baby. If don't nobody else love y'all, if don't nobody else remember y'all, Lyfe remember y'all. Y'all ain't even got to pay for these. These free. That's my word. That's my word, son. But everybody else, I do got mobs to feed. I do got mobs to feed. Lyfe, the soundtrack to your life. Turn it off, Rich. Tape over it.